In this video, you will learn a few ways of creating a clipping mask in Photoshop. Don't go away. Hi, I'm Barry Callister, founder and creator of photographersfreedom.com, giving you the time, gear, and skills to be the best photographer you can be. Welcome to my channel and thank you for watching one of my videos. This video assumes that you already know what a clipping mask is, but just in case you don't, there's a link in the video description below to my clipping mask Photoshop blog post that will teach you all you need to know about clipping masks. But right now, let's learn how to create one. Okay, so here we are in Photoshop, and I have this sunset image here open, and I'm going to type some text and use the clipping mask to make the image show through the text. Now, if you want to download and follow along with this image, there's a link in the video description where you can do that. So the first thing we need to do is come over here to our type tool, select that, and I'm using Impact as my font, but you can use whatever you want. I just wanted to use Impact because it's a really wide font and it'll give a lot of area for the image to show through. So the size, don't worry about the size at this moment because we're going to click and drag to resize it anyway. But make sure your text is white. So click on the color picker there and select white and click OK. Now you just click anywhere in your image and we're going to type sunset. Make sure it's all capitals because that's going to help our effect. Tick up there to say that we like that. Now, in order to resize this, we go Control T, which is Command T on a Mac. Click and drag that to the center. And then if you hold Alt or Option and click and drag from the corner, we can make it really, really big. And this will make it look pretty awesome when we apply the clipping mask. So I'm going to say that's okay there. It's not in the middle, but it does show. It's covering up the little bit of the sun there, so that's going to shine through the text and that'll look really good. So select yes up there, we want that. Now in order for the image to be clipped to the text, it needs to be above the text layer. You can only clip layers above to layers below. So as you can see over here, this layer is currently locked, which means we can't move it. So in order to be able to move it, we have to unlock it. Now I'm using Photoshop version 20.0.5 here. As you can see, I'm using Photoshop CC. So this may be different for you, but if you're using Photoshop CC, all you have to do is click on the little padlock and that will unlock the layer. And then we can then drag it above the text because that's where we need it. Now what I'm also going to do is create a solid color layer on the bottom so that we can see this effect better when we're finished. So come down here to our adjustments layer icon, click that, scroll up to solid color, select that, choose white and click OK. And we're gonna click and drag to bring that layer all the way to the bottom. So now we have our layers in the order that we need them. We need to make sure that the layer we want to clip or apply the clipping mask to is selected. So just click on that layer in the layers panel and that will make sure that it's selected. Now the first method of creating a clipping mask is to right click on the layer in the layers panel. So once you have it selected, make sure that you right click over here to the right of the name of the layer. Don't click on the thumbnail because you'll get a different menu pop up. So right click on the layer itself there. Now in this menu here, halfway down, you'll see create clipping mask. Simply click that and wow, look at that. That is a fantastic effect. It's pretty damn cool. And you can see that down here next to the layer thumbnail, we now have this little downward pointing arrow, which shows us that that layer is clipped to the layer below. So I'm going to Control Z to undo that. And we'll look at another way of creating a clipping mask. Now this second method is by coming up to the layer menu up here, click on the layer menu. Now down here under layer mask and vector mask, you will see create clipping mask. If you click that, you get the same effect. I'll undo that again. Now the third way is by using a keyboard shortcut. So you will see in the layer menu up here, Next, to create clipping mask, it shows us the keyboard shortcut, which is Alt Control G, or that is Option Command G on a Mac. So if we do that, if we press Alt Control G, we get our clipping mask. So that's a really cool effect. This is just one thing that a clipping mask can do. I will do videos on other uses for clipping masks in the future. And that is three ways that you can create a clipping mask in Photoshop. If you learnt a lot from this video and you'd like to see more of my vids, please hit subscribe and ding that notification bell. Also, before you leave, give this video a like and leave a comment. I'd love to hear from you. Until next time, I'm Barry Callister for PhotographersFreedom.com. Get out there, take some wicked shots, and I'll see you soon.